Hey everyone, and welcome to Gaming with Vindicator, where we're building the city of Mikelsfjord. Today we're building a medieval town around this ruined castle. Because of its ancient history, this whole area is being designated a UNESCO World Heritage Site. What's UNESCO, you ask? Well, that's the United Nations agency that protects the world's most important cultural and natural sites. And this particular location has been settled since the time of the Roman conquest in this area, dating to the year 110 AD. It was abandoned for a time during Rome's decline, but was resettled in the year 479, also known as the Dark Ages, when the Frankish Prince Clovis established his castle here. The fortress obviously lies in ruins, but today we're going to turn it into a living museum, and we'll bring to life the city that has stood here for 1500 years, which was founded by the ancestors of the people who still live here today. Let's go! Great, so what I think we'll do is we'll start by fixing some of the problems that maybe I created in previous episodes, and that is related to this traffic mess. It's absolutely unmanageable, so we'll try to make this a series of one-way roads and see if that fixes the problem. I've also noticed that this can be a little bit hairy at times with traffic backing up onto the highway, so we're going to go ahead and be preemptive and double lane that. Still pretty wild here, so I wonder if maybe we want to disallow traffic coming in this way. Let's see where they're going. Oops, didn't want to do that. Maybe I did. So now everyone's coming out, okay. And we have no access to this. What happened here? No access. Oh, nobody can actually get there, so what we need to do is leave that alone. We'll give it a minute and see how that performs. In the meantime, let's take a look at our bus route that we created in the last episode and see how it's doing. That's the one, okay, so a little bit of traffic. But I don't see any passing of passengers, perhaps up here. All right, that's kind of expected. It's at the subway transfer station. But I don't think anyone's being left behind. So it looks like that bus station is doing just fine. We're saving 59% of car trips. That's good. Okay, let's get our medieval town set up. And I think the first thing we need to do, we absolutely have the most perfect asset for this build. So we're gonna go in here, and I think it's number 3, yes, the Old Market Street. So this is exactly what you want for a medieval build. Unfortunately, it's gotta have a road attached to it, so I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of eyeball this and try to put in a flat pad so we don't get any kind of wonkiness. Now where would that fit properly? Let's see if we can get it in here. How's that fit? I don't hate it. I think we can live with that. We might need to do just a slight bit of terraforming, but this can be our main hub of this city. And the next thing we want to do is get some roads in now. I'm going to follow the contours of the hill. I'm going to try not to go too crazy with expanding this too large, but I do think we want to minimize the terraforming because this city has been here for literally a millennium and a half, and we want it to look like it's an old, jumbled mess of small little streets. So let's see if we can do that now. Alright, how does that look? Fairly chaotic, fairly medieval-like, I suppose. Let's go and fix some of the areas that are maybe missing zoning / crazy cliffs. Let's check that out. I think that's fine for zoning, but let's put in a few more cross streets just so that it's a little more, there's a little more connectivity, and that would be a little more realistic. Okay, how'd that turn out? I won't complain about that. That actually works all right. One other thing I want to do is run a collector through here. So somewhere along the river, I eventually plan to extend the city into here. This will be the new new part of the medieval city. And I think we also need to run a train line through here. So eventually we're probably gonna run a parallel passenger train line from maybe this station over here, bring it across, run it along this line, maybe even another collector road in here for backup access, and we'll pop out here somewhere. But for now, we're just working on the medieval section of the town, so we got to get that collector in anyway. Let's do it. I don't really want to hear those planes all day, so I'm going to turn that audio off. The soothing sounds of my voice without the airplanes. Here we go, let's do some grading. So you can see I haven't done anything fancy, it's just a real set of straight roads, and I only wanted that there so I can use it as a placeholder. We can fix that later, but there's a reason I wanted to get that road in before I do the rest of the town, because I plan to put in a wall. This is a castle, right? This is a medieval town. It should have a wall around it, so we're gonna get to that. And the next thing I want to do is, you know, there needs to be some kind of access to the town, so I'm thinking we'll figure out a way to connect this junction with a low capacity road at least. Thinking we might have a significant amount of traffic, so I'm just gonna stub in a little bit of a collector. Four lanes should do it. Great, all right, the next thing we wanna do is actually create the park. Now, I know this is a Nordic build, but I was in Prague several years ago and I came across a castle called Visarad, and I think that just sounds amazing. So we're gonna call it this Visarad Castle. Great, check out our policies. We're gonna wanna get this going as fast as possible, so we'll make it a main park, advertising. Fireworks, not really. Night tourists, check, and these are not applicable. So there we go. And what I'd like to do is put, this road is obviously the road up to the park, but I'd like to put a few park buildings that will allow this to level up. I'm hoping that's enough. We'll see what we can actually get in here. Okay, I'm not gonna let that worry me too much, that deal with that. Let's start sticking in some amenities, and you know what, while we're at it, we might as well let this run. I don't see why not. Well, we'll see how that goes. Let's get some water and some power up here. Great, and let's make sure we have a connection to this area. But actually, I want to put a ferry in there, so we're going to wait on that one. And we'll wait on the power only because I think we can do that by sticking in some zoning. So let's see, what do we need to do next? This park is fairly operational at the moment, so we'll wait till we get some power in there, and then we'll do some detailing. Let's check if there are any other topography issues and sort of smooth out some areas where we can put our services. And I think that's going to be in this area near the old medieval town. Leave that hill. Let it slide. Okay, it seems like we're fine indoors there inside the town. But I do, as I mentioned, want to put a seawall in here. And I don't want to do that in a way that's going to get all wonky, so we're going to just smooth around the edges and make sure that we can get a nice smooth quay wall. I think it's a flood wall or whatever they call it. Well, here goes nothing. Let's see how it turns out. Maybe we can ditch this set, pull it only up to here. Do I like this? I might pull this back just a little bit, see if I can get in there. Okay. Yeah, that looks relatively believable. I think we're gonna leave it there. And if we have to rejig it, we'll rejig it. Let's check the heights. It's not doing any, well, okay, I spoke too soon. That's reasonable. Now let's be honest. This asset, this flood wall, it's not really a medieval asset. I mean, it looks fairly new, but hey, we're in vanilla and this is what we have to work with. And so we're gonna use what we've got at our disposal and include our imagination. Great, what's next? Seawalls, let's do a bit of this downtown district. We're gonna need some services and we're gonna need some commercial districts, perhaps some parks around the area. Let's get into it. And what I'm trying to do is maximize coverage. So I think if I put it somewhere here, we'll at least cover half of the city, and we can probably stick in another one over there once we need to. So this will do for now. Let's get in a fire station for some protection. I'm gonna avoid eliminating those rocks if I can. Not loving the coverage, and that's probably a function of how winding these roads are, and how maybe it is even a function of the dirt roads. Maybe they just don't expand coverage as much as the regular roads. Just trying to figure out where our residential district is going to be, and that's going to determine where I put this. But I think probably this will all be commercial. And I think we'll start to see some residential all around that area. We'll just get it in there. And there's one other thing I want to do, which is create a proper district. And given the ongoing challenges in the world, I think a little homage is in order here. And I know, again, this is not a Nordic name, but we're gonna play to what's in my heart today. There we are, the Kiev district. And I have all of these housing packs installed. Of course, this is a vanilla build, so we're not using these. But we do have the European option, which comes with the base game. You just have to enable it, at least on PC anyway. And I want to use that because I think those will be more close to what we're going for as a medieval theme than the regular districts. So we're also going to make this a green area slightly. We want to make sure nothing's burning down because the buildings are close. Parks and rec, sure, why not? Education, no. We definitely want these people to be working in the port and the airport areas here. So actually we're gonna do the opposite of the education boost, which is schools out. We're gonna prefer ferries, which will become clear, or will make sense in a minute. And free Wi-Fi, sure, why not? Anything else here that we wanna include? Of course, we're going to want a high-rise ban, a heavy traffic ban. What is Old Town here? Only residents and businesses. I'm not sure exactly how that affects the area, so I'm not going to touch it. Workers' union improves people's happiness. Why not? And I think that'll cover it. We've got our European policy in place. Let's start zoning some things, and let's get some parks in there as well. The problem, of course, is that even our smallest parks are rather large for an area that would, you know, it was developed hundreds and hundreds of years ago. There probably wasn't a lot of green space. This is a mountain, it's a castle, everyone's trying to get inside the city walls. I'm not sure how much realistically we'd see in the way of parkland. We do have Visarad, which will give the surrounding area a boost, you know, I'd like to get in at least one or two. You know, a Japanese garden doesn't fit the aesthetic, neither does a tropical garden. I'm thinking maybe just a simple dog park, and we'll put on the back side of the mountain so that we get coverage where we don't have enough. And why don't we throw in a carousel? And I'm going to do everything in high density here because I think the buildings will just look better for a medieval area. I'm really not sure how well buildings will develop on here, so we're going to just leave it alone. In fact, we'll start dezoning some things that look funny. It will be interesting. The development pattern here with the hills, it's going to be wild. And of course, we don't have any industrial demand, which is related to office space, but I need to get some in here to buffer the noise from the high density industrial. So we'll just put a few tiny little offices in here. I really don't know how that's gonna work. I think maybe we'll just leave that alone. In fact, I'm rethinking this, and since this is a more commercial area, let's put in a plaza. Yeah, that looks reasonable. That looks good. Okay. Let's get some residential in here and take care of some of this demand. And I'm gonna start to run it, see if we can get the power in here. Just putting a few little nodes of commercial here to see if we can't get the power to jump, and I don't have to run an extreme power line over into this area. I suppose I could run it behind. And we've run out of demand for commercial, so that's not going to develop. Let's see if we can just get just temporarily a house or two in here. Come on, develop. Let's run it at speed. Come on, do it. Okay, so For some reason, maybe there's too much noise, those are not developing. I'll just have to put in a temporary power line. So ugly, but it's temporary. And we've got to get power up to the castle. So let's see if we can't get these to develop. There's one, two. It's coming, slowly. Oh, and of course, I forgot to put in a high school. And frankly, I'm not sure where that's going to fit. It's relatively large, so I've been resisting flattening this mountaintop off, and I think I'm going to continue to resist it. So where? This might not be the worst idea in the world. There she is, we've got our high school. Not that we need educated people here, but such is life. And the electricity continues to reject me, so we'll just do a temporary line there. And get our park functional, get our high school functional, and we've run out of demand for basically everything, so I'm not sure we're gonna have enough time in this episode to fully develop everything inside the castle walls, but we've got to start. I think the next thing I want to do is, we're going to need some public transit in here, so let's run a bus line snaking through these highways from the junction here, where you can transfer to go downtown, up to the castle and into the commercial district. Oh, and I think what I forgot to do is, I need a secondary connection. This is the only way into this area. That's a mistake. So what I do want to do is put a ferry in here. Let's get the key wall in first. All right, now that we know where a ferry is gonna go, I'm probably gonna end up redoing this road a little bit. And here we go. A single stop location will definitely suffice. Roads here, and it's gonna be tight, but we can do it. We'll run it that way for now, knowing that this will almost certainly change. Okay then, and we'll need a ferry line. Now this is admittedly very tight, so we're gonna do our best. Yeah, there's no way I'm gonna be able to save all of these rocks. In fact, I think I'm gonna have to widen the... Well, maybe not. Widen the river entirely. Yeah, there you go. Water required. Let's see if we can come at it from this side. Ooh, it's so tight. So much for saving my rocks. Let's deepen this waterway a little bit. That's probably the most realistic option. Now, what is happening here? There's a nice vortex in the universe here where the water's just not leveling out. So I'm not sure if that's the rocks. I hate to delete them. Although that probably would be smart given the amount of ferry traffic that's going to be coming through here. Let's see if I can level this out a bit. I'm not sure if that's the rocks or that's the depth or the width of the river. I might try just deleting some of the rocks on this side. We'll back this off a bit. Well, we can go all the way, but we get that weird bend, so we're gonna fix it. Oops. Okay, are we connected all the way? Ah, to here. And that would make sense logically to connect up to this one, so we're just gonna do a straight line. Should be connected to the network. And I don't know if this actually caused a problem, but I just don't like it, so we're gonna smooth it out. Okay, there she is. We have got a ferry line. And it's just gonna need, of course, its water. I'm gonna connect, obviously, this area up with this up here somehow. Might make sense for me to jog this down. I mean, obviously in the medieval times, people would have needed to come down to the river for their water, for their washing, etc. So, you know, there's sense in leveling this out a little bit. Okay, that is ridiculously steep. We're gonna have to rework that. I can say that's better, can't I? Yeah, that's better. And now we connect to this junction. It's looking great. Okay. We're doing okay. And of course we're gonna need a ferry line. Let's get that operational now. I'm creating a separate line because I don't want 1,000 new ferries to come out of the depot and start doing overkill, right? There's very little population in this zone as yet, so we're not going to overdo it. We'll see how many did they put on that line. Let's check. It's this one. We'll call this the Kiev line. Should probably go back and redo those. Four boats. Yeah. Okay. We'll actually reduce that to three for now. See how that does. Get some water in here. Excellent. We have a back way into town. I'm hoping this junction doesn't get too nutty. Let's check the stop signs and whatnot. The light, that's gonna do it. That'll be perfect. Here, it's so far not much traffic. We'll just turn this off. And let the traffic flow. Here, we don't need lights. Maybe stop sign, let's see. Shouldn't be any other stop signs or lights in there. Hey, is that looking medieval? It's looking European. Whether it's medieval or not, that's up to your imagination, but that castle sure doesn't hurt, which by the way came with the map, so I lucked out. Now one thing I need to do is this tower is just not in the right spot. I wonder if we need another one up top here. Okay, how's our demand? We do have a little bit more commercial demand. Let's throw something in there, I suppose. Actually, these are not... Oh, they're developed. Okay. I wonder why they didn't expand all the way out. That was slightly odd. Let's see if I can fix that. And we'll bolt these just to see if they'll develop to their full potential there. Same thing happened over here. I wonder why. It's beyond me. This is probably just a little bit too high, I would say. All right, well, we have pretty much run out of demand, so I don't want to do too much more, but I do want to throw a bus line in here to take people around town. And I'm gonna add a stop here on both sides, just so that we have a transfer opportunity. So we'll come up, and we'll stop at sort of the main junctions. Let's think about where we want to go. You know, in fact, let's hit the stops that we want to stop, and we can add additional stops along the way once it's time. But I think probably it would come up here, go to the park, maybe loop around the main drag here. We don't need to go too far into the city. One here. Another here. We're gonna start to go around to the back of the town. We don't don't need a ton of coverage. Just enough so that people can get around. I'll stop there. It's a mess, definitely. The road system in here, not designed, just basically developed over time. And I don't love that this is gonna have to loop around in the airport area, but hey, could be worse. Okay, so we've got our major stops in. Let's see if there's any other ones we want to put in. Probably makes sense to do a barrel line, but I'm gonna just let it go and see how it works. What we will do, given that this is a really tight street system, and given that there's probably a lot of hills, we're gonna switch these over to minibuses. This is the Kiev line. To me, that makes sense to make it the brightest Ukrainian yellow that we can. And the type of bus we want is the minibus. And it's only carry like 20 passengers, but well, it's gonna give us quite a few buses, I'm sure. So we'll let that run. And while I'm here, I wanna go back to the bus line that we created the last time, which I'm already for, made it yellow, so we'll probably have to change. Yeah, let's just switch that out. Orange, boom. And we've got 65 passengers for 10 buses. That's not great. Ooh, and we have a whole lot of people waiting here. Where are they trying to go? Well, they're trying to get to the airport area. So if we have 116 people waiting, we're gonna need 3 additional buses. Let's bounce this vehicle count up to 13. Oops, there we go. In fact, I'm gonna leave it at 14. That was a happy accident because I think we're gonna have a lot more population moving into this area. Eventually, this is gonna be where we're doing the rest of our residential development. In fact, I'm seeing we have a lot of that now, demand that is, so let's squeeze some more houses in. Thinking we're gonna want also a new node of commercial. Makes a lot of sense to have that around the ferry. So we'll put in some buildings there, line this street. Now these roads, some of them might need to be upgraded eventually because they're gonna be carrying a lot of traffic. For now we're just gonna leave them as is and see what happens. Another little note of low density commercial in this area, since it is a junction that connects us with the outside world, so it's likely that there would be a little bit of shopping here. Yeah, and can we kill that power now? Can we kill this residential now? I would love to remove some of this residential, but it's probably powering our city. How are we doing on traffic for this? I think these are just still coming from the station, so I don't think they've had a chance to actually pick anyone up yet. We'll let that run. It might be next episode that we have to take a look at that and see if it's at capacity or whatnot. So what else? We've got our ferries. You know, I think perhaps we'll leave it here. We've got a whole new city, a medieval city. We are obviously creating new traffic problems that we'll probably have to fix in the future episode. But I'm happy. I'm very happy with the way it turned out. We've used one of our coolest, I think, assets in the game, which is the Old Market Street. We've built up a little, you know, ancient cityscape here. We're going to continue to do that in the next episode. We're going to put in more and more buildings. Obviously, this is high density because, you know, very tight spaces, not a lot of wide roads. you've got to build up if you want to build at all. So, and we've expanded our ferry line. Let's see how this guy's doing here. He's got 4 passengers. I'm sure that's not the most efficient use of our resources, but as this city becomes busier and busier, it's going to evolve. Just making sure, yes, so we've captured the ferry area, which means that our prefer ferries option will hopefully serve us well. The castle, okay, still at 1 star. Let's take a look and see why. We've got plenty of entertainment. It's really just about the visitors. So, you know what? That's going to happen eventually. Look at all this traffic coming in here and all these buses. They'll be there, but hey, at least people have now an option to get up to this world-class UNESCO World Heritage Site, which includes this beautiful ruined castle. So, all right, I'm going to leave it here. Thanks, everyone, for watching. I really appreciate it. And if you enjoyed it, please hit the like button. And if you want to see more from me, just click that notification bell and you'll be updated whenever I get a new episode pumped out, which I hope to do a lot more of in the near future. Thanks again for watching, and have a great one.